Now to the Tahoe area, where experts are using a new network of lightning sensors to help prevent destructive fires. Lightning fires start in some of the most remote spots in California, so it can take days to see smoke. By then, a fire could be out of control. Now, the Tahoe Basin is home to a network of sensors that can detect a lightning strike within 100 feet and then alert firefighters in less than a minute.
This is one of those sensors, positioned at the UC Berkeley Central Sierra Snow Lab.
There are two metal plates.
It's one of nine keeping watch for high-risk lightning in the Tahoe Basin.
Basically, lightning will disturb this electromagnetic field, and it'll be able to pinpoint where it was based off of that.
It was developed by the Fire Neural Network team. The group got its start in Florida, the lightning capital of the United States. Its purpose is based on one big idea.
Not all lightning is created equal.
FNN's Caroline Comeau says that a strike lasting just 0.2 milliseconds, the blink of an eye, is enough to ignite a wildfire.
The strike is touching the ground 1,000 times longer than normal strikes.
FNN's sensors single out those lightning strikes, then use data on fuel type and recent weather to predict the potential for an ignition. The data end up here in a color-coded dashboard.
These big red dots are considered the high-risk strikes.
CAL FIRE will get alerts and coordinates to within 100 feet for any high-risk strikes.
That's going to be substantial on us, not only fire suppression efforts, but stocking that response up appropriately.
Battalion Chief Nathan Menth says it's the randomness of lightning that creates the biggest challenges.
Lightning doesn't select to land next to a road necessarily, right? It's that access.
FNN sensors can alert them of a threat in just 40 seconds.
That alert process happens, and then the human element can come in at that point, validate, verify, send resources if need be.
Instead of waiting for smoke, which could take days. Snow Lab lead scientist Dr. Andrew Schwartz says that's exactly why he wanted to help bring the FNN sensors to the region.
And hopefully the sensor network gets away from that waiting game and becomes we can become a little bit more proactive.
CAL FIRE says it uses every tool at its disposal to fight these remote lightning fires, but it's always on the public to be aware of the risk and to be ready this time of year.
If you are informed or if you gather intel or information that there is a lightning fire, don't wait for the evacuation warning or order to come.